Okay, welcome to my new channel, Simple Italian Cooking. So today we'll cook together a dish that I call spaghetti ad ragù di manzo, which is basically spaghetti with a minced beef and a nice tomato sauce. So I show you first of all the ingredients. We got a few herbs from my little garden. Can you show my garden? See, we got an olive tree, and from this olive tree I got these olives. We got rosemary, we got salvia, we got a little bit of mint, and of course garlic and onions. These two things are not from my garden, but olive oil, very important. It's homemade, home-pressed, extra, super holy virgin olive oil from my father's land. The quality of every dish depends very much on the quality of the olive oil, and everything I cook will be done with this olive oil. And then, if you come closer again, ingredients. You need polpa. But to be clear, I'm not getting any money for this. I'm not doing any advertisement. I'm just saying this is a brand that I like very much, and today I'm using this brand because it was a special offer in the local supermarket, but you can also do it with other brands, but again, it's a brand that I like very much. Same with spaghetti, it's one of the good brands, but of course, feel free to choose also other brands. Okay, one thing I forgot to mention, basil. Very important for almost any dish that you prepare. And in addition to that, I would like to show you fresh organic beef from a local butcher. And finally, also a little bit of red wine, always good, always makes a little difference in the sauce. A few more things I forgot to mention. This leaf, whenever you prepare meat, it's very important. I don't know how you call it in English, but if you know, just leave a comment in the comment field and tell me how we call this. Lorbeer, right? And of course, whoever enjoys a little bit of spicy stuff, chili, is always good. I like it, but attention, when you eat with kids, better not use it. But in case you use it, I have also a little tip for you. Sugar in a way equalizes taste of a spicy food, so you get the good ingredients of spicy food, but it does not really taste that spicy as without sugar. So it's always a good way to cook. And a little bit of pepper, and that's it for now. I'm now cutting the garlic, and I've turned on the olive oil at low flame. Olive oil, always cook at low flame, don't heat up too much, because it will destroy the good taste and the good things of olive oil. I will now add some onions, red onions, and then let's see when it starts making the first noise. Increase the flame slightly. Okay, I'm now cooking the onions together with the garlic and a few olives. This is a very crucial part in this cooking. I cannot overcook these onions, so it's now the time to add a few ingredients. First of all, the meat. I will just add it, and at the same time, now I need to add also the rosemary. Just make it a little bit smaller, so it will not bother you while you're eating. It will actually, in a way, it will melt away these rosemary leaves while cooking. And so again, the crucial part, because now I will have to add a few other things. And let's see if I can do this right today. For example, this leaf, lorbeer. Again, if you know the English word, please let me know, ideally via the comments field. I will make it very small so you won't really feel it when you eat the sauce, but the taste will be there. There you go. Time to add a few more things. Some more olive oil. The meat likes that, and we also do. And now listen to the sound of the wine. I will add also a few mints. And I will cook for another 2-3 minutes before I add the tomatoes. Okay, 5 minutes later, this is how the sugo looks like. And now it's the time to add a few more ingredients. First of all, perhaps this amount of salt. And very important, basil. And let me stir another time. I want to say, I usually like the concept of quick slow food, meaning slow food, but in a way that it is easy preparable. This dish takes a little bit more time to prepare, but the actual cooking time, I mean the time when I'm involved in preparing this, is not that long. I will explain to you later. So we are pretty much close to the end. We just need to let this cook for about 1, 2, or even 3 hours at very low flame. The longer it cooks, the better. See the difference? Oh, by the way, a little bit of sugar, always good. Perhaps this amount or a little bit more. Okay, and finally also a little present for my little daughter, for my little 7-year-old daughter. She really loves it. Right, Alessia? A bit of chili, peperoncino. Will always make a difference, just a little bit. See. If it was just me, I would eat the whole. Okay. Very low flame. The basil almost melted away. Same with the garlic slices. I did very small garlic slices, so you actually don't really bite on garlic, but you have all the good taste and the good. Ingredients of the garlic inside the sugo, and in a few minutes I will do a first test. So now it's time for first taste of the sugo, if it's well cooked. So I take a piece of bread, I will stir a little bit, look, and then I will tell you how it tastes like. Bit hot. Very good. Live on air here, Thorsten. Okay, now the big moment. We will put the pasta into the boiling water. That's very simple. You see, the sauce, sugo, has been cooking and we're ready to eat. We'll boil for 11 minutes and then we will start pasta. Okay, we got here spaghetti size number 5. The beauty of this is that it has a longer cooking time. And I will now make the test if it's al dente. And it's a little bit harder than it should be, but when we mix it with the sauce, the spaghetti, the pasta, will get a little bit softer. So it's better to not cook it too long and take it out while it's still a little bit hard. And now I am putting it out into this here. And yeah. I use this wok to mix the pasta with the sauce, so it's easier to spare small sauce. Now look at this beauty. Look at this. All right. Ready to prepare the plates. Look how many people we can feed. Some Parmigiano Reggiano.